Adult me can be any number, and sigma can be any positive number. The special case when they are 0 and 1 respectively yields the so-called standard normal distribution. So the standard normal distribution is just a normal distribution where the mean is 0 and the standard deviation is 1. We are going to be using this distribution extensively. Now, calculating the f of x for different x's yields the following graph here. So that's the standard normal, the standard deviation is 1, and the mean is 0, as can be seen here. The top of the curve is always above the mean. Okay, now let's work on this graph here. Because this function is so important, we don't actually have to calculate it by hand like we did. R has a built-in function that defines it. Type the following function in the script file. D norm, D goes for density, norm goes for normal. 0, mean equals 0, SD equals 1. What that means is the following. You are telling R to calculate f of 0, where f is the normal distribution, or the density is the normal distribution. The 0 here is x equals 0. The mean of the distribution is 0. And the standard deviation of the distribution is 1. The result in the console is 0.398. So let's confirm that. D norm, mean 0, SD 0. There you go, 0.39. What this means is the following. If you plug it in 0 here, meaning here, and if mi is 0 and sigma is 1, substitute it here, you're gonna get 0.39. You can also see that in the graph you generated. If you look at 0 here, this is 0.39 in the f of x here. Okay, now back to constructing the graph. First, I'm gonna create a sequence of x's. It's a vector of x's. It starts from minus 3.5, it goes all the way to 2.5, and it's increasing by 0.1. So basically, the sequence is minus 3.5, minus 3.4, minus 3.3, etc. I'm varying them by 0.1. You can go here, generate it, and print it. There you go. You can see that the sequence is large. Okay. Then, for each x, I am going to generate a y. The y would be f of x, where f of x is the normal distribution, for each respective x, where the mean is 0 and the standard deviation is 1. So notice that instead of putting a number here, like I did here, it's the same command, but I'm telling R to do that for every single x in the vector that I defined above. So let's do that. Here we are. This is my y's. Now, this first y is f of my first x. In the figure, it would be more or less here. My first x and then my first y. This second y is f of my second x, and so on. So now I have a sequence of x's and y's, where y equals f of x, which is given by this formula here. Okay, now we can plot. I'm gonna plot x and y. The type of the graph I want is a line, and I'm gonna put a label in the y-axis. The label is f of x. So let's see how that looks. And here it is. That is my normal distribution of mean 0 and standard deviation 1. But now, let's program in the function again, and then calculate some probabilities. This time, I'm going to do it the hard way again, by programming the function itself. Notice that this is a simplified version of what I had before, because the mu is 0 and the sigma is 1, so the function gets easier. But it's the same thing that we had before, but now I don't have to subtract 1 because I don't have to subtract 0, and I don't need a denominator here because the denominator is 1. So the formula gets simplified to that. So let's redefine f. Okay, now I'm interested in some special numbers here. And they are special because I'm going to use them a lot in econometrics. If x behaves according to a standard normal distribution, I want to know the probability that this x is in between minus infinity and minus 1.96. This number here is what is called a critical value. We're going to be using that a lot in econometrics. So basically, instead of rolling a die, you are actually drawing an x from a population that is normally distributed, and you're going to look at this x. What's the probability that this x is between minus infinity and minus 1.96? This probability is 0.025, or 2.5%. Now let's calculate another probability. The probability that I draw an x from a standard normally distributed population, and this x happens to be between minus 1.96 and plus 1.96. Now look what I am actually asking. Here's minus 1.96. I already know that the probability that x is smaller than that is 2.5%. And because the normal distribution is symmetric, it is also the case that the probability that x is larger than plus 1.96% is also 2.5%. It is symmetric. Each side is a mirror image of the other. Okay, but now I am asking what's the probability that x is in between this critical value, minus 1.96, and this critical value, plus 1.96. As we saw in note 3, the probability that x is in a region like that is the area below the density probability curve, which is indicated by this green area here. And I already know that it has to be 95%, because if this is 2.5% and this is 2.5%, this has to be 95%, but let's do it anyway. Integrate f minus 1.96 plus 1.96. That is 95%, or 0.95. Okay. This is going to be extremely important for us later, so keep that in mind. Meaning, the critical values, minus 1.96 and 1.96, and the fact that if you randomly draw an x from a standard normally distributed population, the probability that x is in between these two critical values is actually 95%.